Like I said before the game, you know, they've been playing pretty good hockey thus far, and you know, we knew we had to come out with a good start, and we knew we were going to have to play 60 minutes.
Yeah, well, you had to play a little bit more, about 22 seconds more. Take us through the goal. It starts with DZ behind his own net.
Yeah, it's a good pass by Gabby here, back to Michael right there. That's a great pass by Michael to enter, or Gabby to enter the zone, and then Michael just brings it to the net. We get a nice little bounce off a skate, and then Gabby makes a great pass over to Michael, and Michael makes a great pass back to me. So it was, you know, it was a pretty good passing play by those two guys.
Are you screaming for the puck right here because you know the net's wide open?
No, I'm just kind of sitting there making sure that if he does want to pass it over, I'll be sitting there waiting for him. So
kind of speaks to the level of communication, even nonverbal, that you guys
have.
You know,
Mike's a great passer, too, and I knew that he would look to pass on that one, especially because everyone was diving in front of him, so he made a great play.
It's a 2-1 game for a long time, and unfortunately, I couldn't come up with a save there to keep it a 2-1 game, but as long as we got the 2 points, it's still a tricky game when you're, I think, that much better, because I really think we were. You just have to stay patient. You can't, you know, start trying too hard to get the next goal. You just have to let it come to you, and I think we did a pretty good job.
Did that goal maybe exemplify why Rick Nash is going to be so sought after over the next week?
He's a good player, no question. I've faced him a lot over the years, the national team and here in NHL. And you know, a skilled guy, strong with the puck and a great shooter. But, you know, we're used to now over the years to have a lot of speculations this time of the year. I don't really pay attention to it too much.
Derek said that he wasn't calling for the puck there. Did you know as soon as it was coming to you that you were going across?
Well, my first thought was I knew I had open net, but I gave Gabby an earful for not putting it in my wheelhouse and throwing it on my back end. But as soon as I got on the back end, I knew the goalie was going to slide across, just desperation play and same with their defensemen. So I knew I had step wide open.
What was the mood like on the bench when what seemed to have been going on as a regulation win became overtime?
I was fine. You know, we said to ourselves, you know, just keep going out here, keep battling. We played a pretty solid game, a couple unfortunate penalties in the offensive zone, and we shot ourselves in the foot. But, you know, you look at us throughout the whole season, we're a character group, a lot of resilience, and we just showed it again tonight.
What was it like for you when you came in the locker room thinking you had scored before the buzzer and finding out you didn't?
I was a bit upset, but it would have been a big goal for us, but at the end of the day, it didn't happen, and we just want to keep moving forward. We sat in the room, you know, let's not let it get down on us and just keep moving forward and have a good third.